click to subscribe to the channel and then press the bell icon to get regular updates of videos, live sessions, and important seminars.
For prelims, you should have fixed sources again. Multiple sources I would not advise, because I have spent a lot of time in old Rajendranagar. I have spent a lot of time in this exam, and this is what I feel. You should have fixed sources to shorten the time, shorten the duration of this exam, your stay. You should have multiple revisions for prelims, and you should devote 2-3 months, as ma'am said, before prelims. You should dedicatedly devote time for prelims, but before that it is a holistic preparation for prelims and mains both. Test series, as far as test series is concerned, there are a lot of good test series in the market, but I would suggest if you are appearing for prelims after completion of your course, you should go for more than one. If you do not complete one completely, 35-40 tests, it's okay, but you should go for more than one. It is going to help you diversify your approach, diversify the kind of time management, or you can say the type of difficulty of questions that you're going to handle. It is going to diversify your approach and mindset. So go for more than one test series. And one more thing, what I feel is you should not go for group gyan that is prevailing in civil service aspirants, that you sit together and you go on discussing your foreign policy and all, especially not before your prelims and mains. So don't waste time in group studies if you can manage, but if it clicks for you, group studies, it is very good, but don't waste time. Just my point. And time management in paper, do practice test series, and time management is a really important thing. Many of my friends couldn't go through the prelims paper last year. It was sort of a different paper that came last year. It was not conventional. So many people were surprised in the paper last year prelims. So they were not able to go through once. So time management again is very important. Despite what sort of difficulty UPSC throws at you, you should manage your paper well. For mains, writing practice again, and that too within 3 hours. If you practice any test paper, please practice it within 3 hours, within the time limit. If you exceed, you are going to hurt yourself in the mains. I did that mistake during my initial mains, but within 3 hours, practice it within 3 hours. And one more thing that many of the aspirants have started doing and have been doing is daily answer writing practice. Many coachings, you must be aware of it, many online portals, many coachings provide daily questions. They provide daily questions, 5 questions, and they also provide model answers. So it is one thing that is drastically going to improve your answer writing skills. Daily answer writing practice, 4-5 questions from any online portal or any coaching in the market, that is your choice. And current affairs, you should read newspaper. That is my personal opinion. It is definitely going to help you in one way or the other. An interview in mains and prelims, I felt it very useful. Choice is yours, Hindu or Indian Express. I've read Hindu for 4-5 years. Then I switched to Indian Express. It is your choice. Both are good newspapers. But you should read newspapers. I think this is the most important thing. And many of the people misguide sort of that it is not important. You are going to get current affairs booklets in the market anyway. Yeah, definitely you are going to. But you are not going to get that perspective that is being needed in the mains answer writing and in an interview. You should read newspaper. But within a limited time frame. You should not spend 4-5 hours on it. One and a half hour is decent enough for the coverage. And now, for the coaching, ma'am has already covered whether you need coaching or not, given your level of preparation, the stage that you are in college. You should go through some of the topper strategies. They are available on YouTube. I did this mistake. I never saw any strategy, never saw any guidance. You should see some of the topper strategies, but do not follow blindly. You should try to pick and choose whatever suits you best, but do go through some of them which you feel right. One thing I would like to point out, we are at an age where we are distracted very easily. Not so long ago, I was on that side of the podium. We get distracted very easily. And we have social media, mobile phones, smartphones, Instagram, WhatsApp, and whatnot. So I would suggest just maintain a distance from it. If you can switch to basic phones, it's okay. If you cannot, just delete some of the apps and stay away from it. and other distractions also, your personal relations, your personal life, just keep that in order. Before and during the preparation, it is going to affect you. It is definitely going to affect you. Never ignore it. Just manage everything. And have a social life. Do not go into isolation during the preparation. Have a social life. Talk to your friends. Talk to your family. Just keep in touch with everyone. But within manageable levels. It is about management only. It might sound hypothetical, but I have many friends. As I was discussing with ma'am, and most of them have cleared now. It helps. I should have a social circle. And follow strict schedules. Most of you must be having planning and just posting notes, sticky notes, what time to wake up, what time to sleep and all. Follow. We all plan, but we don't follow. Just follow your schedules, follow your study plans strictly. Try to achieve all of your targets, daily targets. Maintain a plan for small targets and try to reach them. Prelims is near. I think if any one of you is appearing, this is the time to plan and to execute. Newspapers, I have told, optional is very important. Optional is really important. I have interacted with some of the students, some of the aspirants who got into the services. Optional is a decider. At the end of it, it is going to give you a rank, or it is going to decide whether you're out of the list after giving your interview. Just be very rational. Do not be very emotional that this is my graduation subject or I really like this subject. Just go through the test series, give test series, see how you are performing, whether you have an aptitude that matches with what UPSC wants. Don't be too emotional while choosing your optional. If you want, you can drop also after spending some time on it. But don't be too emotional. See how that optional is performing in UPSC. But just do some research. Just don't go through emotions that I'm going to take this subject. Just be a little rational for optional. And for prelims, do not assume anything. For example, last year prelims was a bit tough. From aspirants' perspective, I'm telling this. It was a bit tough. Do not assume anything. Presume, rather, that it is going to come this way. That it is not going to come from static. It is not going to come from current affairs. It is going to be this and that. Do not be a planner. You cannot outsmart UPSC in any of the stage. Just do not plan. Just prepare your studies and give the exam. Do not presume that where is it going to come from or anything. It is very important. Many people do that and it doesn't work. For motivation, now you would be very high in motivation. It is your starting stage. I really wish you do not spend too much time in this preparation and get through very early, first attempt, second attempt. I really wish. But if luck doesn't favor you or your preparation doesn't go through that level, motivation, you would need a lot of motivation. And I think self-motivation is the best form of motivation. No other external form of motivation can help you in the long term. So just keep yourself motivated. Just think why you started this preparation for. You must have some motive. It can be anything. It is your very personal view of this exam. But just remember why you started and why you need to finish it. And please do not stop before finishing it. Thank you.